Hello, friends. Welcome to Virtual Team Jesus Sunday School. I'm Deaconess Kim. Let's call Judy up here so we can get started today. Hey, Judy, come on out here.
I just can't do it.
Well, hey, Judy, are you having a problem today?
Yeah, I cannot get my necklace on.
Well, here, would you like me to help you with that?
Yes, that would be great.
All right, I know that these can be tricky. Let's see, we get that tied on like that. It is a very nice necklace, though. It matches your outfit very nicely.
I know, I love my cross necklace.
There we go, almost. And there we go, all done.
Okay, thanks, bye.
Wait a minute, Judy.
What's wrong?
Didn't you forget something?
Well, I don't think so. I have my necklace.
Well, Judy, after I helped you, you forgot to say thank you.
Oops. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you for helping me.
You're welcome. You know, you forgetting to say thank you does remind me of today's Bible event. Let's check our Bible box for our clues.
Really? Did Jesus help someone with their necklace?
Well, no. Jesus did something much bigger. He healed 10 men who were very, very sick. However, only one of the men thanked Jesus.
Well, I guess they all forgot their manners.
Well, would you like to learn a little more about that Bible event?
Yes.
Okay, first, let's practice our Bible point, though. I'll say the first part, you say the second part.
Okay.
Okay, we go, Jesus helps us. Now you say, we thank Jesus.
We thank Jesus.
Great. Do you think you can teach our friends?
Sure.
Okay, everybody, we say, Jesus helps us.
We thank Jesus.
Very good. Let's practice it one more time. Jesus helps us.
We thank Jesus.
Great. Now, today's Bible event comes from the Gospel of Luke. But before we listen to our story, we do need to talk about leprosy.
Leprosy? Wait, is that great big spotted cat in the wild that's like a lion?
Not quite. You're thinking of leopards. But actually, leprosy does have something to do with spots. It's a terrible sickness that causes people to have a lot of painful spots all over their bodies like this.
Ooh, like chicken pox?
Well, sort of, but much, much worse. Leprosy is rare today because we have medicine. But in Bible times, no one wanted to catch leprosy because there was no medicine to cure it. If someone had leprosy, they would probably be sick forever. Other people wouldn't want to be anywhere near them. It was painful and very lonely.
That sounds terrible.
It was. And in our Bible story today, there's not just one leper or person with leprosy, there are 10. So let's open our Bibles and read about what happens. Today's Bible event is from Luke chapter 17. Jesus was on the way to Jerusalem, traveling along the border between Samaria and Galilee. As he was going into a village, 10 men with leprosy met him. Leprosy was a very bad skin disease, and those who had it had to live outside of the city, away from other people. So they stood at a distance and shouted loudly, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us!" When Jesus saw them, he said, "Go, show yourselves to the priests." They turned and went off to find a priest. Only a priest could declare that they were free of leprosy. As they went, they noticed that they were healed. Their sores were gone. Their pain was gone. Their skin was clear and clean. One of the 10 men, a Samaritan, when he saw that he was healed, ran back to Jesus, praising God in a loud voice. He threw himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. Jesus asked, "Were not all 10 men healed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this foreigner?" Then Jesus told the Samaritan, "Get up and go. Your faith has made you well."
Wow, leprosy looks awful. They were all wrapped up in bandages like mummies.
Yes, they were very sick and they needed help.
And Jesus helped them.
That's right, Judy. Jesus healed them of their leprosy.
All of them? Even though only one of them came back to say thank you.
Well, based on what the Bible says, I think so. It says they were all healed, but only one of them came back to thank Jesus and praise God.
Well, I'm glad I don't have to worry about leprosy. Blech.
Well, we also have a terrible sickness like leprosy, Judy.
We do, but I don't see any spots on my arms.
It's not like that. Our leprosy is called sin. It makes terrible spots on our spirits and keeps us away from God.
Oh, no!
Well, don't worry about it, though, Judy. Jesus heals us, just like he healed the lepers in the Bible event. When Jesus died on the cross, he took away all of our sin.
So Jesus is like medicine?
Well, Jesus is pretty good medicine, the very best medicine, actually. Jesus heals us of our sin. And then we should remember to be like the one leper who came back.
Oh, we should thank Jesus for healing us.
That's right. Jesus heals us of our sin. And in response, we thank Jesus.
But how do we thank him?
Well, one way is by saying it like normal in a prayer.
That makes sense.
But we can also say thank you in other ways.
Like what?
Well, another way we can thank Jesus is by helping other people.
So Jesus helped us, so we help other people.
Right. So every day, pay attention and watch for ways that you can help other people as a way to say thank you to God for helping you. Now, let's say thank you together by praying. Fold your hands and repeat after me. Dear God.
Dear God.
We love you.
We love you.
Help us remember to thank Jesus.
Help us remember to thank Jesus.
Who helped us.
Who helped us.
By taking our sins away.
By taking our sins away.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, that's it for this lesson. Remember that God loves you so much. Thank God for Jesus, who helps us. Have a blessed week.